All right, folks, how you doing? So just a couple of minor corrections from the last video I did, which was the Scotland Stirling Air in Glasgow. There was a couple of things that I got slightly off. Now, the first one was not really my fault. There was a slide talking about Stirling and Tron. Let me see if I can find it. The trouble is, there's no such place as Tron here in Scotland. So the slide, the Burgess listings, the book now pivots to Burgess listings from Stirling and Tron. So I'll do the screen share. There we are. So this is what comes up when you type in Tron into Google Earth. So there's no such place. What I think they meant to say was Troon, which is down here. Having said that, that's quite a long way from Stirling, so I'm not quite sure where they were going with that. There's Stirling up there, there's Troon all the way down there. But like I say, anyway, now the next thing that I got slightly wrong was the Tow Cross. You type in the Tow Cross, this is what actually comes up. It's a big T. What I think I meant to say was the Kabbalistic Cross, and I just kind of got them slightly mixed up. Not sure if I'm even spelling that right. No, so the Kabbalistic Cross, when you go into the images, you can see what comes up. So that's what I meant. When I said Tow Cross, I really meant the Kabbalistic Cross. And it's kind of bizarre because coming out of this, hang on, stop sharing. So, the authors, they're a little bit muddy on this point. Maybe this is just me being nitpicky. But let's go back to the book when Scotland was Jewish and talk about the Tow Cross or the Kabbalistic X, which they also say is like the Templar X and all the rest. Well, I'll screen share it and you'll see how I kind of got mixed up with that. So this is from the book itself. You type in tau, comes up. There's seven references in total. So, where's the first one? I'm not having a great day with technology. Anyway, the seal of William Fraser, Bishop of St. Andrew, show a man in a central tau position flanked by Islamic crescent and six-pointed star. Covered that already. So, the tau Kabbalistic symbol. By the X, so that's where I was getting it mixed up slightly. We must consider the coat of arms for Cowan symbolism in them as revelatory. First of all, carried the Tau Kabbalistic symbol X, so that's how I got it mixed up with the Tau cross. But I think they're separate things. The Tau cross and the Kabbalistic X cross are not quite the same. So, in my opinion, the book was being overly simplistic there because when you actually look it up, the Tau cross is a big T. So it's more like the Tabalistic X. The Tau Kabbalistic X, I should say. Beg your pardon. But yeah, so they're not exactly the same. And their spelling of Kabbalah is very strange as well. Because you'll see it. For example. There's a whole chapter, Knights Templar, Freemasons, and Kabbalah. There's 36 results come up. The way of spelling Kabbalah is pretty odd. When you type in Kabbalah, oh, that must just be the old way of doing it then. Interesting. Or maybe that's how it comes up in another language. Okay, so Kabbalah, a traditional esoteric occult or secret matter. Ah, so this is the old spelling, it must be. So it's interesting. The Hermetic Kabbalah. And there you've got the Tree of Life. Kabbalistic symbols. Well, that's not the traditional spelling for Kabbalah, that's for sure. Because when I go back, that's the main Kabbalah spelling. K-A-B-B-A-L-A-H. Jewish mysticism, essentially. When you type in the Kabbalah cross. Yeah, that's what came up before. But then Google is trying to correct you, saying, do you mean the Kabbalah cross? So are these the same thing? Or are they slightly different? Or is it just the old spelling? I don't know. You tell me. Because it's kind of bizarre the way that they chose to do it like that. At least in my opinion. I don't know. I'm a newbie at all this stuff anyway. Let me know in the comments below. But I just thought it was interesting that they chose to spell it that way. Like I say, maybe just the old spelling. But there we go. But I don't really know what they meant by Tron. Okay, so here we go. Tron Parish poll tax in the index and Tron Parish. But where's Tron? There we go. Tron Parish poll tax, 1694. So where's Tron Parish? Oh, okay. They mean in Glasgow. Tron Kirk. Well, they could have said that. They could have made it more specific.
They could have made this clearer.
Right, a nearby Tron Parish. Okay. There we go. See, this is where it got me a little bit mixed up. But a sampling of cemetery inscriptions can only take you so far. Many persons living in Western Scotland may not have been buried in one of these graveyards, and not all inscriptions are decipherable. Show names taken from Burgess's listings in Stirling and Tron. I'm looking for a town called Tron. It didn't occur to me that they meant a church when I put the presentation together. There you go. Okay, and a Tron Parish. Right, now you could have made that clearer just by putting Tron Parish Kirk, because I'm thinking Tron Parish means a town or a village. And I'm looking at the map and Tron's all the way down there. Stirling's all the way up here. Okay, it makes sense now. But, you know, fucking be clear about these things. Anyway, never mind. You live and learn, don't you? Take care.
Over 6 feet tall, below average intelligence, with a permanent blanket look on his face. Hey, this couldn't be you, could it? No, I'm no 6 feet.